Greetings aspirants, welcome back to the second session. I hope the first session that was based on days and organization was helpful for you guys. So today I bought all the sports news that were in news for the first week of June. This will be helpful for all your examination. So without any further delay, let us start. And before going that, I want to give a shout out to all the people watching that this is my new channel, right? This is a new channel. So share it to the maximum people, like, share and subscribe, so that I'll be motivated, so that I know that my work is doing some improvement in your life, because one day or the other you will crack the examination. I know, I have complete belief in you guys. So let us start. So there was a news in Forbes, right? World's 100 highest paid athletes of 2020. So Roger Federer topped the list, right? He belongs to where? He plays tennis, right? He's plays tennis. What is his worth? His worth is 106.3. His worth is 106.3 million. Question may come, because previous, since the last 1 year or two, they have started asking questions on the worth of the persons, right? They have asked you who is the richest person, what is the worth of the second richest person according to Forbes and others. So 106.3 million, Roger Federer. So since Roger Federer came, so remember one thing regarding Roger Federer. He belongs to where? He plays tennis. Then he belongs to Switzerland, right? Switzerland. Then what is the capital of Switzerland? Bern. What is the currency? Franc. And he is the only living person of Switzerland to have a coin commemorated in his name, right? He is the only living person of Switzerland to have a coin commemorated in his name. So again, Naomi Osaka. Now, since we know in men, Roger Federer has topped. And then in female, who has topped? She is Naomi Osaka. She belongs from which country? She belongs from Japan. So capital is what? Tokyo. Currency is yen. One of the currency of SDR, Standard Drawing Rights of IMF. Right? And then Japan will host 2021 Tokyo Olympics. Right? It was supposed to be in 2020, but it was postponed to 2021, and she will represent, Naomi Osaka will represent Japan. And what was her net worth? Her net worth was 37.4 million. And she has become the highest paid female ever. That means till this date, the Forbes ranking was announced, no one has earned 37.4 million. This is the meaning. That means Naomi Osaka, 37.4 million was her net worth. Right. Again, as number one marks the first time a tennis player has held the top spot since the list inception is Federer ranking. Wait, this is the first time a tennis star has been on the top since the rankings of Forbes were published, since 1990. So since tennis came into play, what do you need? ATP, Association of Professional Tennis. Where is the headquarter? Headquarter is in London, right? London. So again, there is the news. Ronaldo became what? Ronaldo was second in this list. Roger Federer was top with 106.3 million. Ronaldo was second with 105 million. But in the football history, he became the football's first ever billionaire. He is the first one to repeat the feat, right? And then he is the what? He is the leading goal scorer, active goal scorer in internationals. After him, who is there? Let me clear this. Cristiano Ronaldo is number one in active goal scorer list. And then after him, who is Sunil Chhetri, captain, fantastic, from India. These are, I'm talking about active. I'm not talking about all-time scorers, leading goal scorers. I'm talking about active. That means who are still playing. He belongs from which country? He belongs from Portugal, right? Portugal. Capital is Lisbon. Currency is Euro. Now, again, Virat Kohli. Virat Kohli is the only cricketer in Forbes to feature in that list. But he is the only cricketer. His earning is 26 million. So, since Forbes is in news, it is important. Headquarter is in New Jersey City. Jersey City in where? In Jersey City in US. And then Mike Federle is the CEO. Now again, this news. Adidas India appoints former Miss India Manushi Chiller as brand ambassador. Right? She is not the only one. There are many persons. Again, Adidas has been saying that Adidas will donate $1. Adidas will donate $1 for every hour of fitness activity clocked on the Adidas running and Adidas training apps until 7 June. That means it has passed. So that means anyone will clock per hour, Adidas will donate how much? $1, right? Manushi will, since I told you that she is not the single brand ambassador, Ranbir Singh is there, Rohit Sharma is there, Hima Das is known as what? Dhing Express, right? Dhing Express. She belongs to Assam. Another thing you need to remember here, there's a campaign going on. Home team hero. So, she has been, Manushi Chiller has been roped in with the other star to support what? Home team hero. Since Adidas is in the news, let us check the details of Adidas. So, Adidas is a German company, right? CEO is Kasper Rosted. And where is the headquarter? Headquarter is Herzogenaurach. Herzogenaurach in Germany. Adidas headquarter is a German brand. Its headquarter is in Herzogenaurach. And Kasper Rosted is the CEO, right? Now, since again, Manushi Chiller came into news. So, on menstrual hygiene day, Manushi Chiller teams up with UNICEF to spread awareness about menstruation, right? It's a very important topic, right? Nowadays, every girl should be proud of her cycles. So, the 23-year-old has joined hands with whom? UNICEF. The former Miss India runs her own initiative, Project Shakti. Again, another project came, Project Shakti. Why these are important? Because India is talking about woman empowerment. Since every world is talking, the topic is woman empowerment, everyone is talking about woman empowerment. So this kind of campaign schemes play a major part in our examination. So Project Shakti. What is Project Shakti? Project Shakti initiative of which personality? That is Manushi Chiller, right? Now, Dia Mirza, Dina Penty, Aditi Rao Haider, these also, this is the picture. She posted a picture on Instagram for the Red Dot Challenge. So question may come, Red Dot Challenge. Red Dot Challenge is associated with what? World Menstruation Day, right? That is on 28 May. Again, for you guys, all the fans of Manushi Chiller, she will be coming in a historical drama called Prithviraj opposite Akshay Kumar. So, all the fans of Manushi Chiller, wait for this movie. She will be hitting the screen soon, right? Now, rankings has been announced, right? And then India is at 108. No gain, no loss. India has been in 108 since many months. So, let us check the ranking. Here you can see in women, who is there? USA is top. And then in men, Belgium. Since Belgium, capital is what? Brussels. What is the currency? Euro. Right? And then, what are organizations in Brussels? NATO. Right? Then, World Customs Organization. These two are in Brussels. There are many organizations, but these two are important. Because whenever you learn a trick, it says that any organization beginning with W, that means world, and ending with organization would be in Geneva. But this is the exception. So So remember, World Customs Organization is in Brussels, and then NATO. Recent NATO meet was where? Recent NATO meet was in where? Was in London. London, UK. Right? USA. Do you know a person USA? Megan Rapinoe. She is my favorite footballer of the female. Megan Rapinoe. She was 2019 Ballon d'Or female. Here I will write down. Ballon d'Or feminine. And then she was FIFA Women Player of 2019. Chances of asking are, Megan Rapinoe belongs from which country? She belongs from USA. Now, India to host 2022 AFC Asian Cup. So let us check the facts of India, Indian football. So now, since India is going to host what? Asia 2022 Asia Cup. So what is important? Important is what? Who is the chairman, president of Asian Football Confederation? He is Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa. Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa. He is from Bahrain. Bahrain, Manama, Dinar. Manama is the capital. Currency is dinar. And then when it is formed? In 1954. Right. How many members are there? There are 46 members in Asian Football Confederation. You can see his face, right? Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa. Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa. Burj Khalifa, Al Khalifa. Right, remember like this. So again, since who is the captain of our senior national team? Loingtham Bam Aslata Devi. That means since 2022 it is in news, right? Who will be leading? That means we don't know in 2002 who will be leading, but currently who is the captain? Captain is Loingtham Bam Aslata Devi. Now remember, she belongs to Odisha. Many people think she plays for Odisha, but that is wrong. This is wrong. She plays for Tamil Nadu Football Association, and she is the captain. She is the captain, right? Captain of the senior team. And she has been named AIF Player of the Year 2019. So AIFF Player of the Year of 2019, Loingtham Aslata Devi. Now, after merger, next news. After merger, ISL and I-League champion to go by ATK Mohun Bagan from 2021 season. So, the news is ISL and I-League champion who? ATK Mohun Bagan. Like ISL champion who? Kolkata. Right? Atletico di Kolkata and I-League champion Mohun Bagan are merged into a single entity called ATK Mohun Bagan. So they will be known as ATK Mohun Bagan, right? So I-League they will play, and then they will be known as ATK Mohun Bagan. Now, SAI, Sports Authority of India, has launched what? Khelo India e-Pathshala. So the news that you have to take from here, the medicine, the solution you need to take from here is what? Khelo India e-Pathshala, that is the first online coaching program. For what? For grassroots level in association with National Sports Federation. National Sports, what do you mean by National Sports Federation? That means archery, golf, right? Weightlifting. These make the National Sports Federations. The program will cover how much? 21 sporting disciplines. And then what are the games? You don't need to remember the games. That's it for the taking writing I have given. Now, Kiran Rijiju launches 25-day Khelo India Community Coach Development Program. 25-day, how many days? Khelo India Community Coach Development Program is for, what is the duration? That is 25 days. Who is Kiran Rijiju? Minister of Sports and Youth Affairs, right? And Youth Affairs. He is from Arunachal, constituency is Arunachal West. So this program, Khelo India Community Coach Development Program, what does it do? What is the purpose of this? So the purpose is to equip 15,000 physical education PE teachers and community coaches across India, right? Now let us go to the doping bans. Now we have seen that there are many doping bans going on. So let us go through the which player has been suspended, which player has been given a clean sheet. Let us check it. So now let us, you need to remember this. How questions are framed. I will show you how questions are framed. They will ask you, now look at this news. Asian bronze winner, javelin thrower Davinder Singh Kang hopes for clean sheet in doping disciplinary hearing. So Davinder Singh Kang is associated with which sports? He is a javelin thrower. He belongs to which state? He is from Punjab. Right? Now, this is important. Indian runner Gomathi Marimuthu, she is from Tamil Nadu. She was the Asian champion of last time from 800 meter Asian champion. Was banned from the sports for 4 years by the Athletics Integrity Unit. Right? So let us check the facts of Athletic Integrity Unit. So, who is the president? Sebastian Coe. Where is the headquarter? Headquarter is in Monaco, right? What is the capital of Monaco? Monaco capital is Monte Carlo. And currency is dinar. Now, Khumukcham Sanjicha Chanu, she belongs from where? She belongs from Manipur. She was the winner of 53 kg. She represents which kilogram? She represents 53 kilogram. And she was the gold medalist in Commonwealth Games, cleared of doping, IWF. So let us check the facts of IWF, International Weightlifting Federation. So how many members are there in IWF? There are 192 members in IWF. It was founded when? 1905. Where is the headquarter? Headquarter is in Budapest, Hungary. What is the currency of Hungary? Hungary currency is forint. Forint. Hungary, capital is Budapest, currency is forint, right? So, who is the president? She is the interim president. That means she hasn't been appointed permanently. Her name is Ursula Garza Pependria. Right? So Ursula Garza Pependria belongs from which country? She is from United States of America. Now again, long distance runner, Kiranjit Kaur. She is from which state? Kiranjit Kaur represents Haryana. She was the winner of what? Tata Steel Kolkata 25K Elite Women India. She was not the winner. There were two races. One was overall in Tata Steel Open, right? Tata Steel Open running competition. There were two categories. One was overall. She didn't win. She was fourth in the overall one. And then in India category, she won the first prize. She got a 4 year ban. So if dopings are there, then WADA and NADA will play an important factor, right? What is the world body? World body of doping is? This is the world body. This is on the national level, right? This is on the national level. Let us check the facts of WADA. Where is the headquarter of WADA? Headquarter of WADA is at Montreal, Quebec. Headquarter of WADA is World Anti-Doping Agency. Headquarter of WADA is Quebec, Montreal, or Montreal, Quebec. Now, who is the president? Witold Banka is the president of what? WADA, World Anti-Doping Agency. He belongs from Poland. Poland capital is Warsaw, right? And what is the currency? Zloty. Poland capital is Warsaw, currency is Zloty. Now, how many members are there? If question comes in deep, so we must know how many members are there. It's not about what is going to come in exam. I'll only study what is required for examination. No, you have to study everything. Why? Because नॉलेज इज द ओनली थिंग यू कैरी ऑन विथ यू. पैसा ये सब चला जाएगा, लेकिन जो सरस्वती माता है ना, लक्ष्मी माता चली जाएगी, लेकिन जो सरस्वती माता है वो हमेशा हम में बसेगी. तो माता का नाम लेके जय सरस्वती माता हम लोग आगे बढ़ते हैं. देर आर हाउ मेनी मेंबर्स? 12 एग्जीक्यूटिव कमिटी मेंबर इन वाडा अल्टीमेट पॉलिसी मेकिंग. एंड हाउ मेनी आर देयर इन फाउंडेशन बोर्ड? एग्जीक्यूटिव इन एग्जीक्यूटिव कमिटी देर आर 12 मेंबर्स. एंड देन इन फाउंडेशन हाउ मेनी मेंबर्स आर देयर? देर आर 38. Again, declaration is important. Since you know, all the students, I think you know about the Bretton Woods conference. Bretton Woods, let me clear this, I'll explain. Now, Bretton Woods conference, under which, what? Under which, this is a homework. You need to study about the Bretton Woods conference and Bretton Woods twins. So, Lausanne Declaration on Doping on Sport. This organization associated with the Lausanne Declaration on Doping in Sport, right? Established on November 10, 1999, right? Director General is Oliver Nigley. Headquarters is Quebec, Montreal, Canada. And then Foundation Board, Witold Banka, Poland, Warsaw, Złoty. Warsaw is the capital of Poland, and then currency is Złoty. Foundation Board, there are two board governing boards, right? One is 38 member in Foundation Board, and then Executive Committee, there are 12 members. Now NADA, National Anti-Doping Agency. So who is the brand ambassador of NADA? Bau Bhaiya, can you remember? Chanda Meri hai, Bau Bhaiya, Sunil Shetty, he is the brand ambassador of NADA, National Anti-Doping Agency. This is in Indian level. And on the world level, who make all the decisions? World Anti-Doping Agency, that is WADA. So, governing body of NADA, Kiran Rijiju, as I have explained, Youth Affairs and Sports, ex-officio. Ravi Mittal is the cabinet, is the secretary. You need to remember this, Ravi Mittal. He is the secretary, Department of Sport, Ministry of Youth. Who is the secretary of Sports Ministry or Youth Affairs Ministry? He is Ravi Mittal. Again, who is the director general? Mr. Nabin Agrawal is the director general, right? These two are important, and he is also very much important. Headquarters is in New Delhi. Anything associated with ministry, headquarters will always be in New Delhi. Now, obituaries. Archery coach Jayantilal Nanoma passes away. Archery coach, because India has a good ranking, right? A good ranking. In archery. So, the name, what do you need to know? Jayantilal Nanoma is associated with what? He is associated with archery. He was an archery coach. So, let us go to the information board of archery. So, Archery Association of India, headquarters is, as I said, majority of under the ministry headquarters would be in New Delhi, right? And then, office bearers, these three are very important. New appointments. Mr. Arjun Munda. He is the tribal affairs minister. He is from constituency is Khunti Jharkhand. Right? Khunti Jharkhand. Jharkhand is important because why? Four players for the under 17 football World Cup, which is to be situated in India, is from Jharkhand. So during the COVID-19 pandemic, what is happening? They are not even getting good food because they are not from, they don't get a high income. So what Jharkhand government has done, they have given them 10,000 for June and July month. Who is the vice president? Abhimanyu Sindhu. And then, who is the, again, two vice presidents there? Amandra Singh Bajaj. So Arjun Munda, you need to remember. Now, Bobby Morrow. Why he is in news? You may be thinking, sir, why Bobby Morrow is in news? Because he was a three-time gold medalist, three-time medalist of the Olympics, right? Olympic sprinter. Three gold he has won. So he belongs from what? From United States of America. So Sai, I was discussing news about Sports Authority of India, right? So who is the Director General of Sai? Sandeep Pradhan, right? Headquarter is in New Delhi. You already know New Delhi. And then who is the Secretary of Sports Authority of India? He is Mr. Rohit Bharadwaj. So they have done something regarding the stipend. They have announced to give a stipend to all the players associated with Sports Authority of India. So go through the news. It will be a revision for you guys. Now, India, I told you, India is at 108. Now, female, India men is at 108. Now, woman ranking is what? 50-50. India is 50-50 in woman ranking in football. India is in 108. Now, against FIFA. Now, FIFA, who is this person? He is Gianni Infantino. FIFA headquarters is where? FIFA headquarters is in Zurich, Switzerland. Zurich, Switzerland. Capital is what? Switzerland, Bern, and then currency is franc. What is the full form? People don't know the full form of FIFA, right? Federation International de Football Association. Federation International de Football Association, right? He is Gianni Infantino, the president, right? And then how many members are there with 211 affiliated associations? So you may have seen one thing. I always get the details from the official websites. Why? What is the reason? I could have made a text box, I could have made a table and write it down there. But there is no use because I have seen for the past many weeks, many months, there is confusion. Some educator is giving this, some educator is giving that, but I don't want that for my students. Because what? It's better to be what? Sad than sorry. Yes or no? Because I don't want you guys to lose one mark or 0.25 marks for me if I don't know. I am a human being, right? To err is human, right? To forgive is divine, there's a saying. So I am a human being. So I may also sometimes what? It happens with the best of us. I may also forget some things. But if I forget anything, I will say I don't know. Because it's better not to say it either than saying it sorry. Because I don't know if the rectification videos are being watched by the students or not. So there are 211 associations, right? And then Gianni Infantino. I think World Bee Day. I think Environment Day is clear. World Environment Day on June 5 is clear, I think, right? The theme was what? Biodiversity. Biodiversity. Right? Not the time for nature. Not the time for nature. Because I have given you from the official UN sites. And I damn sure know what? That UN people know better than the educators teaching on YouTube. Now, since there is a news of FIFA, so where is the FIFA futsal? FIFA futsal World Cup in 2020 would be in Lithuania. And then under 17, I was telling, right? Under 17 would be in where? In India. Now, FIFA under 20 Women's World Cup would be in Costa Rica and Panama. Costa Rica and Panama. And then who is the defending champion? Japan. That means under 20 Women World Cup defending champion. Last time Japan has won, and 2016 winner are what? Korea DPR. And then these three teams will represent Asia. And then who is the futsal winner? Who is the current futsal winner? They are Argentina. Argentina. What is the capital? Buenos Aires, right? And then Piso. Buenos Aires is Argentina is the safe haven for all the criminals, right? All the criminals, money laundering criminals and everything, they go to where? If anything, any problem arises in their own country, they take safe haven in where? Argentina. And Buenos Aires is very famous for that. Now, UNICEF. We are talking about the news of UNICEF, right? UNICEF. UNICEF director is what? Henrietta H. Forrest. She belongs from US. So our headquarters is in New York. And then menstrual hygienic day is on 20th May. Theme is what? Periods in pen. This is important. Anything, I keep on repeating this, anything related to woman is a important. Manushi Chiller, red dot challenge, right? Red dot challenge. Yes or no? Yes. Ha. Now, who is the coach of our Indian football team? That is senior. Igor Stimac. Who is the woman coach? She is Memol Rocky. And who is the captain of our senior woman team? Ashlita Devi. Rambingam something Ashlita Devi, right? She was born in Odisha, but she plays for Tamil Nadu. Now, woman under 17, right? Thomas Leonard Dennerby. Who is the coach? Thomas Leonard Dennerby, right? She's under 17 World Cup, will be held in 2021. So this is important. Now, our Indian captain is who? Sunil Chhetri. He plays for Karnataka. And current club is what? State association is Karnataka. And then current club is Bengaluru, right? You understand state association, right? And then the current club, ISL, and then what? What was that? I-League. He was called Captain Fantastic. So this man is second highest active goal scorer. Before him, who is? Cristiano Ronaldo. He plays for Portugal. His club is Juventus. Their ground is Turin, right? Juventus Turin. And then Juventus is a which league? Serie A. So, AIFF, who is the president of AIFF? Praful Patel. Praful Patel is the president of All India Football Federation. What is the headquarter? Headquarter is in New Delhi. Headquarter is in Dwarka, New Delhi. So, guys, this is the part 2 of my appetizer series. That means small, sectional. I'll bring sectional things. For example, political, international, sports, important days, important organizations, and then it would be resignations, then merger and acquisitions, right? And then books and authors. I'll be bringing the appetizer series in this way. So next session would be on appointment and resignations, right? It will be uploaded on Tuesday, 16 June at 5 p.m. And then, so guys, thank you for watching the session. And I request you guys, so that I'll be able to reach all you guys virtually, please subscribe, like and share. And then when you like and share, I'll also be motivated. I'll be bringing more content. I'll be bringing content on securities market, banking awareness, and then SEBI is coming, right? SEBI grade A, RBI grade B. I'll be bringing this type of series for that, banking awareness, where I don't just bring MCQs for you guys. And then this question number one, this tick, I'll make a presentation. This A, B, I'll teach you what? Concepts. Like SDR, then there is leverage ratio, then there would be Bessel norms. Till now, all these things were paid. But yo sir, my name is Deep. Since I have met you guys, I didn't mention my name. My name is Deep. I'll be bringing all you guys. My background is in economics. Don't you worry about that. I'll be bringing all small sessions for you guys, because we teach, we learn, and you conquer. So guys, thank you, namaste, for watching. And one message I want to give you guys: don't be disheartened, because remember, this is a new channel, right? This is a new channel. And whenever I think, why my subscribers are not increasing, there's only one saying going back at my mind. What is that? You know, the first kilometer of a marathon is the toughest in your life. And then you guys are there, I am there, we will together What did Himesh used to say? जे माता दी, let's rock, मुझे तेरे घर से रोटी चाहिए. मुझे आप लोगों के घर से कुछ नहीं चाहिए. Be well and maintain safe distancing. Thank you guys. Namaste and keep watching Aspirants 101.